Three types of business owners. Three types of business owners. You have a technician, you have a manager, and you have an entrepreneur. So let's go through each of these and kind of describe what they are so you can understand. So I want all of you guys who are W-2, which is the lion's share of the room, I want you to start thinking now, okay, I want to be a business owner. Which one do I want to be? And it's okay to start in one and move your way up. That's what you're going to have to do. You kind of start as one, and then you sort of move your way up the line. One technician. Let's dive into it. A technician owns the business. They do all the work. So plumber, electrician, contractor, dentist, accountant, lawyer, hairstylist. Amount of money doesn't matter. Prestige of the business, doctors, lawyers, ditch diggers, doesn't matter. If you're a business owner and you're doing the work yourself, you are a technician. You're doing the work, okay? The pros of being a technician is you have freedom. So you think. You control your own schedule. So you think. And you control your own destiny, right? It feels that way because you have your own business, you've made business cards, and you're ready to roll. Here's the cons to the technician side of business ownership. If you're not working, you're not getting paid. As a technician, if you're not doing work, I don't care, again, if you are a dentist who normally makes a couple hundred grand a year and you're not drilling people's nasty teeth that day, you're not getting paid, right? If you're a sole proprietor, that's it. Limited growth, can only do as much business as he can handle. So busy in the business, they never have time to work on growth and strategy. Never have time to think about what's coming, the pitfalls that might be coming, the avenues of growth they can have, the different areas they can branch off into. They don't have time to think about that because all they do is put out fires all day. All they do is put out fires all day. Now you move up to a manager. A manager is the same as a technician, but now they have people that work for them. So a manager is, you know, the technician that done the work. Now they say, okay, now I've got, you know, a person or some people working for me. It's starting to look like a company. Okay, I know it's a company when it's just you. I've done that many times, right? I've had three different businesses in my life, so I know what it's like to start at the beginning and build it up. But it feels like a company when you start having people that answer to you a little bit. You feel important. Sometimes. Pros. Same as a technician, plus some growth is now possible. Some growth is now possible. The manager can take time off and still get paid. So if done correctly, the manager can manage their people, right, and still get paid. In the real estate investing world, you could jump into this level. You don't have to jump in the technician level because I'm not going to encourage you to go out there and paint and do the work and lift those rocks around. I'm not going to encourage all that stuff when you first start. I'm going to encourage you to kind of jump on the management level because you're going to be managing your people right away. They may not be your employees, but they're going to be contractors that you hire. So for a temporary time, they are your employees, okay? So the cons are you have to work in the business every day still. You're still really working in the business because you're focusing on managing your people, managing the process. There's no or limited time to work on the business and strategy. Limited growth potential. There's some growth, but it's limited growth potential. And the business is dependent exclusively on your personality and your leadership. So it's really all about you. And so if you're the only manager in your business doing things, if you're having a bad day or you crawl under a rock because you go into depression that day because you're under pressure, I wonder how I know that, stuff happens, right? And you're like, oh, I don't want to do anything today. If you do that and you only have a small team, odds are they may fall suit, right? They may do what you're doing. So just, it'll be based on you. Let's go to the entrepreneur. According to the picture, apparently we just stare out the window all day and that's all we do. Although ironically, getting the entrepreneur kind of helps you get to that level of being able to think down the road. Think down the road. So it's the same as a manager, but you can do primarily strategic work. So primarily, you are working and thinking about what could knock me off my track. What's a better path to be on? How can I optimize what I'm doing to put more money in my pocket? How could I deliver more value to my team and to my people that we do business with, which will ultimately put more money in my pocket, right? How do I help enough other people? As an entrepreneur, you start to think to yourself, how can I help people reach their goals? Because if I can help people reach their goals, I can reach my goals. right? You start thinking that way. It's a pretty cool way to be thinking. You can read business reports, so you're reading numbers, where you're getting back to math, numbers, whatever, simple stuff, and you can execute decisions for your managers, or you can make decisions for managers to execute. So let's bring it back to real estate investing. In our world, our team will buy houses. They'll bring it to me, and sometimes they don't have to necessarily. If it's a home run, they can write it up like that house that we just went to, home run. You don't have to question me if you find a house in Colony for 100 grand that'll sell for 300 grand. I don't even waste the time to come to my office and ask me. Just buy it, right? Well, what if it needs? I don't care what it needs. There's 200 grand room. I've got plenty of room. I'll figure it out, right? So, but if you have a team of people that are out there, they can execute those decisions for you. When it happened that we didn't wholesale like we thought, I didn't go out and do the work. Amber actually talked to the project manager and said, hey, do me a favor, go out, look at that house, see what you think it needs, come back, report to me, and let's decide. He came back and said, so not much. And that was the conversation. And so I said, well, do up a scope of work, let's take a look at it, let's just buy it. And so I didn't go out and do anything, and it was taken care of because I was able to execute through a manager. It didn't start there for me. It started with looking at the house myself and you know all that stuff. It started, but now I can delegate and manage as an entrepreneur. Entrepreneur's life, the pros. Get to work on the business, not necessarily in the business. Sometimes my team will come to me and start talking. They'll start talking conversations. I'm like, whoa, weeds. You got this handled. I've trained you. You got it. I'm here. I want to focus on the bigger picture. You guys focus on the weeds. That's what I pay you for. Got it, right? It's better to stay out of the weeds so you can focus on the big picture. Unlimited growth is possible. The entrepreneur can leave the business for months and it'll thrive in his or her absence. Can leave the business for months, it'll thrive. It's truly passive income. I'm not even talking about rentals, guys. That's the beauty of our business. That's a hidden jewel inside of the jewel. The jewel is you build a business that pays you income because you're delegating some stuff. In the middle of that, you're building true passive income because you're putting rental units on your books. Dual income, dual passive income coming in. The business has systems and procedures, is not dependent solely on your personality. I don't know my tenants. I don't want to know them. I don't know my contractors. Don't want to know them. I see them sometimes. Once in a while, they might be in the office or pop around, or hey, I work for you. Oh, great. Wonderful. It's where you can do, it's just a different way of thinking, right? Your business has systems and procedures. The business now has value on the open market. There are people who want to buy that business. If you run a business that's based on a system, you may want to exit someday, and somebody like me or somebody like anybody that's a business owner that wants to get into real estate investing may say, so you're telling me if I give you $5 million, I have a business that will do 25 renovations a year and do this much business. You might be 65 years old and say, yeah, you buy that from me, here's a system, you take it over. If someone has money, which people have money, and they don't want to start from scratch, they could buy that business from you because you built, they're not buying you, they're buying your business. Does that make sense? It has value if you think of it like a business. Even if you're doing five a year and it's a steady system, somebody might pay you $1 million for that or 800,000 or whatever. It has value on the open market. Cons are, you may have to move on to start more businesses. Amber and I own five businesses, not because we said, let's own multiple businesses. Just one feeds the other. And it's like, you know, well, we should do this. Now we're talking about, you know, owning a title company. It's like, well, listen, we're doing so much work. Let's just do our own title company. Now that'll be our sixth business. And we're talking about a credit company. Things come up because as your business grows, just opportunities come. They show up. Right? Question is, where do you want to be?